guys. Today I'm in Dallas, Texas, and I am shooting at Clyde Warren Park. Yep, that's right. We're at Clyde Warren Park, and we're going to be out here shooting with the Gioto flash. Today I'm going to be using that with the Godox trigger, and if you stay tuned, I'll have everything at the bottom at the end of this video so you can see my thoughts.
Samantha, where are you going, Samantha?
I'm going to go get the wagon. Somebody has to carry the wagon.
Where you going, Samantha?
I'm out here in Clyde Warren Park, and I'm going to be using the Sigma 105 with the Sony A7R Mark III. We are using the Gioto flash for this and the Cheetah Stand USB 34 to shoot Coco real quick. Guys, this is Keaton with 924 Photography, and today we at Clyde Warren Park, and we're finna get it done with Coco. And don't be mistaken by the movie, because see, that's what I'm saying. So we're gonna be out here, we're gonna make these bangers today, and I'm gonna be using the Gioto flash. So that's what this review is gonna be. It ain't gonna be so much of a review, but we are going to be just testing this light out, seeing how it does down here in the Dallas area. So tell me, what are you gonna bring to the table for me today?
Everything and then some.
That's what I'm talking about. That's the kind of enthusiasm I like. And if you like this, I want you to go follow her. Hold on, let me let you know where you can find her at. Go.
You can find me on Instagram at Chloe Mae Gibson, or you can find me on Facebook at Chloe Mae Coco, or you can find me on Model Mayhem at Coco.
Boom, and you can find me at your mama's house. Oh. Bow! Guys, this is Keisha with 924 Photography, and I just hope that you enjoyed that video. I'm fixing to give you my conclusion on the Gioto GT200 flash. Using this flash, it felt like any other Godox flash. It was very well built, but we'll get into that in just a second. So while on location, I encountered a couple of things that didn't work as well with my Sony camera. Using their trigger, their 2.4 gigahertz trigger,
It would fire sometimes. Sometimes it wouldn't fire, but I believe this can be fixed with just a simple update. So what I ended up having to do, I had to go to my Godox flash, which it would get on the Godox frequency. I'm gonna show you that in the video as well, how if you own the GT200 and you own Godox flashes as well, you can put this flash onto their same frequency and you can use it in conjunction with your other flashes. How I feel about the light being by itself, I feel like it holds its own. Like I said earlier, the trigger had some issues with me and I went through a lot of different things and I still couldn't get it to function like my other trigger. So the build quality on this flash, it is absolutely amazing. I can't take anything away from it. It is built awesome. You have the battery right here. You can see on the screen, it is on the top part. So you'll pull this little lever back and you could just, it'll pop right up and then you can push it back down. I like that feature because it's on top of the flash instead of on the side of the flash. Not saying that the previous models from other brands had it on the side was bad, it wasn't. I just like it being on the top as well. Okay, so how you turn this flash on, you have a little switch on the left side of the flash. If you're looking at it from the back, you just push that knob up and then your flash will turn on. Now, as we're going through this flash, if you hold the group/channel button down, you can see that the channel is highlighted. So in order for you to move to a different channel, you'll either hit plus or you'll hit minus to cycle through the different channels. If you're wanting to change the group, all you have to do is the group/channel button. All you have to do is just press it once and it will cycle through A, B, C, and D groups. If you are using the Godox system and you need this flash to get on the Godox frequency, what you will do is the plus and the minus sign that's on your left, if you're looking at the back of the flash, you will press those two buttons down for 3 seconds and you will see an A pop up. An A, it just means that it is on the Godox frequency now. So say you wanted this flash to be on group B right now. So all you would do is you would just hit your group and you would just change it like normal. And that will put you on a different group and you can use this flash in conjunction with all the rest. This flash comes equipped with a 1/4-20 thread on the bottom. So in their kit, they come with a little handle that you could put on, and that's how the softbox is mounted onto this flash. Also, some different accessories that come with this flash. You have an adapter piece here. You just unscrew it and you would put the flash in. You just slide it right in and it will stop because it has like a little bump, and then you just tighten down the thread here. And like I said earlier, they have a 1/4-20 on the bottom and they have a pistol grip that you can put on if you need to handhold. Now, this is what's so cool about this flash that I absolutely like. Putting this adapter piece on here, it is magnetic. So if you're at a wedding and you got the pistol grip on and you are running and gunning and you need like a Gary Fong or some type of diffuser to go on the top, they have a dome that is there. So all you do is just press it in and it is magnetic. So now you have a dome. So I am going to turn on the modeling lamp. To turn on the modeling lamp, you just hold the mode/model light down and you'll see the modeling lamp come on. Like I said, this top piece is magnetic, so it makes for a great accessory, especially when you're in weddings and you're trying to just fill in or bounce light. So what comes in the Geek Oto location kit is you have a light stand, you have a small Octobox, you have a pistol grip, and you have the GT200 flash. So the light stand, it is very, very lightweight. It folds in very compact, so this is very travel friendly. Now, just I want you to have a note that this light stand is not built to like really heavy duty for you to have an 8600 or bigger flash on top of here. You would just use your GT200 on it, and it is a great on-the-go kit. Now, this case that I'm showing you right now is absolutely amazing. I like the case that they put it in. All my accessories can go. So if I'm getting ready to get on a plane or anything at all, I can pack everything in once and I can put it in my overhead bin. That's what's so cool about it. So just note that if it's on a windy day, you will need somebody to hold that light stand because like I said, it is very, very light duty. It is not made to hold anything bigger than the GT200 or a AD200 if you have one of those. One downside to using this flash with the Godox system is once you put it in TTL, you cannot change the TTL values. You can only change the values when you are in manual mode using this flash with the Godox system. If you're in the market for this location kit or 200 watt flash kit, that's gonna run you $399. What you get a flash that will sync up to 1/8000 of a second, that is high speed sync, and you get a quick release softbox with the light stand and some other accessories inside of that. As you can see on the screen right here on Amazon, you can definitely go to Amazon and pick this kit up. In the description below, I'll have a link so you can go and find this flash without having to make it effortless for you. Now, if you just want the actual flash, then that will run you $279. And like I said, it's a great addition to if you're already a Godox user. You'll be very, very happy with it, and it is cheaper than the Godox flash. All right, guys, if you like this video, I would love for you to subscribe to my channel and hit that bell so you don't miss another one of my videos when I upload. I'm gonna be doing a lot of reviews, and I'm gonna have photo shoots and everything that's gonna come after this, so hey, stay tuned for things that might help you out in the photography world or videography world. So I am Keidra Franklin with 924 Photography, and I'm going to see you in my next what video. Peace out.